We are doing the vaccine for itching. So the problem is that vaccines are something that everyone kind of needs to prevent viruses and stuff like that. So transporting them is another really big problem. So what our problem statement was, these people in a privileged country in Africa named Waka are don't have vaccines, and they need, people need to be able to transport vaccines to this place. And we found out that 2,000 people need flu vaccines, and depending on that, we are making a box that cools these vaccines to an optimal temperature of 5 degrees, and we'll be able to transport it for, we were thinking, at least an hour.
So this is the village of Waka, located in Afghanistan. As you previously said, the population is 17,000, and 2,000 people in the village, including elders, children, and men and women, need immediate vaccines.
So our solution is to create a box that can fit into the storage part of a motorcycle. It should be able to keep the vaccine vials in 5 degrees Celsius. And it should use like renewable energy, so we don't have any problems while transporting to remote places.
So these are like a few criteria that we focused on. So obviously it needs to be something cheap, it needs to be portable, easy to manage, and it doesn't have any complex parts. Runs on as little electricity as possible, and like as I previously said, needs to cool down at least 5 degrees Celsius. Or 41 degrees Fahrenheit, and be able to carry 4 vaccine vials.
So our first design is the system used in a modern day fridge. It uses a compressor, a vacuum evaporator, a condenser, and a throttling device. We didn't go with this design because one, it's expensive to buy things like a compressor, and also it's not that compact. And it will get damaged on the way to a car. The second design, it's like basically the same as the first design, but it has the ventilation system, which is similar to the design we used in the final design.
Our third design was a thermoelectric cooler that uses a Peltier system. Unfortunately, this was too big for an 8x8 fridge, and the Peltier unit was not efficient enough for mountainous areas such as Afghanistan and to be able to like, purchase.
So the final design for the function of the box. So there is a pump which pressurizes the system that is outside the box. We don't have that because we don't have the electronics to make this pump. And as you see, there is a picture of an engine that you see is right here. It's a small engine and it runs on air. And this will power a stepper motor that is on the box. And this in turn will generate electricity for the box to power the cold plate that's at the bottom and to power the ventilation system. So the design of the box was a regular 8x8 box, which we added hinges with rubber washers on them to have an airtight seal. As you see, we've added some rubber on each corner to have the best insulation possible. And we have a handle for easy opening up the box. So inside the box, there it is. This is not like the best idea, but like we have to add styrofoam and more insulation to it to best cool the vaccines.
Our exit strategy is the patented design and sell to a tech company that can afford the device. We also don't have the money to mass production.
Yes, so unfortunately we had a lack of time and lack of technology in order to like make proper cooling. So what we thought of is, like as you previously said, sell this to a big tech company so they can provide the technology that we need to make the cooler. And since we patented the design, we will also get some of the earnings from that. Thank you for listening.
The concept of the air pump, can that be used outside of this? Have you thought about it?
So the idea that we had was that this should be like a